Bengt Soderqvist is a very unique individual who's lived on the island for so long. There's not many who've lived here as long as he has and can tell a story the way he can. He came here from Sweden, he ended up in the Bahamas, and then from there he came to Turks and Caicos back in 1966. He surveyed all the property, so if you ever want to know anything about any parcel of land on the island, Bengt is the guy to go to.
Well, the first time I saw Providence Islands was actually way out outside the reef, because when we came down with the Seven Dwarfs, we couldn't go straight to here. We had to go to South Caicos. And actually, Providence Islands looked kind of blue. And, you know, in the old days, Providence Islands was named Blue Hills. The entire island was the name of it. And that's probably why, because when people were out sailing, you know, they kind of looked kind of bluish.
I just got the lucky draw. You know, it happened that he was looking for a new partner. They had called me and see if I was interested in working with him. It wasn't so much to work for the company, it was to work with Bengt Soderqvist. To get the knowledge and the history from him. Everybody who meets him, loves him, wants to work with him. He gives a lot of his time, a lot of his patience, and a lot of the history he's willing to share.
My first job was to survey out the 4,000 acres and come up with different sketches how to subdivide the land and where to put the roads and so on. So I was very much involved in deciding, you know, where the roads was going to go on. And I remember sometime I was thinking, because I'm, as I said, in my 20s as a surveyor, and I was thinking if project like that would happen in Sweden, how many people would be involved in doing all this thing, where I was just more or less deciding, okay, let's put the road there, and then we put some flags in the bushes and took the bulldozers and built the road.
There's the typical advantages that, you know, you're on a small island, the community, the way of life, no traffic lights, no taxes, at least property taxes or income taxes. It's a nice way, it's a real community feel. And it's different than any place you've ever lived before, and it's very safe.
We came on that first trip when I said I saw the island from way out there. We had an old army jeep in the stern of the boat, and we actually built us a dock up at Hevendal Rock. And on November 22nd, 1966, we actually took ashore the first motor-driven vehicle on Providence Islands.
National Colony Realty has really been around since Bengt Soderqvist has been around since 1966. We have a history of clients going all the way back to 1966, which no other company can say they have. We've never become a big company. We're small. We have 5 agents at the most at any time. We all work really hard. We work together. We don't work as independents. We sort of work as a group. And we have our faithful leader. We have Bengt. He's always there to show us where the markers are, what the history of the land was. We give a little bit extra that other agents can't give. We give the history of the island before somebody even buys it, which not everybody can say they can do.